All right, together we're going to share in the joys of their wedding, both with the outward celebration of this occasion and with an internal appreciation for the love that surrounds us. Mary and Justin, you two have an opportunity to build an amazing life. You're blessed to share this experience with the loved ones gathered here today to support you as you embark on this journey together. Marriage is truly a magical gift. My very favorite author and humorist, Mark Twain, once noted, "Marriage makes of two fractional lives a whole, and it gives two purposeless lives a work. It gives two questioning natures a reason for living and something to live for. It will give new gladness to the sunshine, a new fragrance to the flowers, a new beauty to the earth, and a new mystery to life." May you all remember and cherish this ceremony for this day with the love we will forever bind Mary and Justin together. Who gives this bride today?
Both her mother and I.
Very good. All right. I've actually always wanted to say this part. If there's anyone in attendance today who has cause to believe this couple should not be joined in marriage, you may speak now or forever hold your peace.
That's what I thought.
I'm really not sure how long I'm supposed to wait after that, but we'll just keep going, okay? When Mary and Justin first asked me to officiate their wedding many months ago, my immediate reaction was, of course, to say yes, and it would be a great honor for me. Justin went on to say that neither he or Mary wanted a religious ceremony. They wanted to keep it very light and funny, And the more he went on to describe the kind of ceremony they wanted, I finally had to interrupt and I said, "It sounds more like you wanted me to do 20 minutes of stand-up or perhaps a roast." And before I even got those words out of my mouth, Justin said, "Yes, that's exactly what I want." Well, in spite of not being much of a comedian, I accepted the honor anyway, and I started to do a little research about how to conduct a wedding ceremony. And this being my first and probably my last, and in the process of doing my research, just about every resource I found suggested that the officiant should spend some quality time getting to know the couple married. And that made an awful lot of sense to me. So, of course, I've known Mary for many years, and I more or less got to watch her grow up from a carefree college co-ed, now more than a decade later, into a confident and mature young woman. But Justin was a little bit different story, and while we had many interactions, I really didn't know him the same way I knew Mary. And trying to find this in the busy world to spend any real quality time together, with even the two of them, it was difficult. So I decided to solve that problem by giving them both a questionnaire about 15 questions with instructions not to collaborate or not to share any information. Pardon me? Oh, you may all be seated. I'm sorry. I didn't know you were waiting for me.
You take direction very well.
Anyway, I was hoping to get some good material and to be able to give them the kind of ceremony they wanted. But when I got their answers back to my questions, I realized I wasn't going to be able to comply with their request to do 20 minutes of funny. So I really hope both the best man and the maid of honor have some good material for their speeches later on tonight, because we're going to have to save all the funny for the party that's going to follow this ceremony. But I've got to tell you that I was truly surprised by the seriousness and the depth of thought that both Mary and Justin gave to the questions I posed to them. And I also realized that these were two people who truly knew each other and who weren't just jumping into the marriage all starry-eyed and doe-eyed. Their responses told me that both Mary and Justin knew exactly who they each were as people. They knew exactly who the person is who they were about to marry. And they know each other's strengths, they know each other's faults and their weaknesses, and more importantly, they know how each of them makes the other better and more complete person. So after that, I knew funny was completely out of the question. Marriage is more than a simple exchange of rings or a contract that involves the combining of material assets. Rather, it's an indescribably powerful shared commitment. While today I will legally bind you together, the true important bonds we form today are largely invisible to the world, existing primarily in the unfilled corners of your heart. Marriage is one of life's greatest gifts, and it is a blessing to make these promises with your soulmate. As you hold on to one another, you'll find deeper levels of joy, happiness, and peace together. Your marriage is the foundation upon which you will build the rest of your lives, and despite any adversity, will always be there to sustain you. The joy you'll find as you pursue your shared lives will fuel you to face head-on the challenges you'll encounter on this earth. On your journeys together, keep your spouse in the space of highest priority in your heart. Learn to work together, to laugh together, and to love together. Don't get caught up in worldly things that will draw you apart. Instead, focus on your shared devotion and turn inward. As your relationship strengthens, you'll find that you'll come to share a remarkable love, a love that is both abundantly given and freely accepted. As we celebrate this bond of unity today, it's important that we keep in mind that while this is certainly an occasion of tremendous joy, the promises we witness here today are serious and life-altering commitments. Love, it has been noted, is the reason we live. As Carl Sagan wisely deduced, the world is so exquisite with so much love and moral depth, we should remain grateful every day for the brief but magnificent opportunity that life provides. The sum of all our evolution, our thinking, and our accomplishments is love. Mary and Justin, I now invite you to publicly speak your commitment to your partner. Would you like to begin, Mary?
Sure. All right. I've been planning this day since I was 5. It might look a little different today, thank God. No pink Barbie convertible. But one thing I could not have come close to imagining was the reality that men like you, Chatty, would be my one day husband. For the past few weeks, I've been reflecting over the last 4 years we've shared together. I remember sitting across from you at Union Ale House for the first time, just amazed at how confident and vibrant and nice you were. Little did I know what I know now.
They warned you.
Fast forward a couple months to our bucket list trip to Napa, right after getting through our first health scare of an allergic reaction that made me look like a botched Real Housewife of Duck Lip City. Then some of life's challenges thrown in, all while finding a new normal as the world turned upside down overnight. We've had tough times and exchanged hurt for awards, but in the same token, I've grown up since you matched into my life. You've helped me achieve goals and supported me without question as I pondered my 9 lives of career changes and ambitions. On our wedding day, we say, I do, but to me that means I will. I will take your hand and walk in stride through the good and the bad. I will laugh with you, cry with you, scream with or at you, crow with you, and craft our life with you. While I will not obey you, I will seek your counsel and consider you in everything I do. I will try to learn patience when you point out that it's been too long since I last ate, all while I'm viciously plummeting into the 7th circle of hangry. I will celebrate your successes and mourn your losses and be at the ready to tackle new ventures when the time calls. I will stop in the moment with you for the spontaneous kiss or embrace, which I haven't at all this week, despite the challenges that may come our way or the level of work mode that has consumed me in a task. I will love you for who you are and for who you are yet to become. I promise all of this to you with all my love that I will choose us every day. That was terrible.
Justin, your turn.
As standard of you, you deliver something perfect and immaculate and still aren't happy with it. Best piece of advice I ever got in my life was early on from my father. He told me, son, no matter the consequences, always be who you are. Much easier to say than to do. We all know that. Now, there's a lot in this life I don't know. But I know who I am, and I always have. And because of that, I can tell you this for sure. I'm stronger with your touch at my side. I'm wiser when I have your words in my ear. My smile's bigger when yours is there next to me. My heart is happier when it gets to share its life with you. I am better because of you. Now, I can't promise you a lot in this life. I can't promise you a trip around the world. I can't promise you a life free of hardships. I can't promise you I'll never forget something or get angry or knowing me do something stupid. And obviously, I can't promise you a life of quiet. Oh, shush. Here's what I can promise you. You'll never live this life alone. You'll never cry without me there to wipe your tears. You'll never fall without me there to pick you up. You'll never laugh without me there to laugh with you. You'll never close your eyes without me there to guide you. You'll never have to live this life without me. Through sickness and health, through poverty and wealth, and until death do us part, I will always love you.
Mary and Justin, if you'd please join hands, which you're already doing, thank you. Mary, do you take Justin to live together in a union of marriage? to take him as your best friend and partner in life, to honor and cherish and love him from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, for all of your days?
I do.
Sure.
Justin.
Hold on.
Do you want a second?
No, move on.
Okay. Justin, do you take Mary to live together in the union of marriage, to take her as your best friend and partner in life, to honor, cherish, and love her from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, for all your days?
Will you try harder?
You have
to. Gotcha. With everything.
Okay. All right, that's good. Okay,
it's the happiest time I get to say I do.
Thank you. Okay.
Can't believe you didn't.
All right. Are the rings nearby and handy?
God, I hope so.
The wedding ring's circular shape reflects the unending power of love, a force with no beginning and no end. You should wear these rings proudly and let them remind you each day of your commitment to one another. Please repeat after me. Mary, you can go first. I, Mary, give you, Justin, this ring as a symbol of my love.
I, Mary, give you, Justin, this ring as a symbol of my love.
As I place it on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
As I place this on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days.
I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days.
I give you all that I am and accept all that you are.
I give you all that I am and accept all that you are. Did I say that right?
Yes, you did. Okay, Justin, your turn.
Oh, boy.
I, Justin, give you, Mary, this ring as a symbol of my love.
Give you, Mary, these rings as a symbol of my love.
As I place it on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
As I place them on your finger, I commit the whole of my heart and soul to you.
I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days.
I promise to cherish you for the rest of my days.
I give you all that I am and accept all that you are.
I give you all that I am and I accept all that you are.
Family and friends, by the power vested in me by the Commonwealth of Virginia, I am pleased to pronounce Mary and Justin as wife and husband, sealed together both in law and in love. Justin, you may kiss the bride after I exit.
We got here and did it. Hallelujah.
Don't have a microphone for this, but ladies and gentlemen, for the first time as husband and wife, Mary and Justin. Yeah.